It was exactly 1 month ago that I spilled the beans on Epson's newest projector launch for the Indian home entertainment markets. And guess who is here at our experience center? The Epson ESTW750 is here. Well, in this video, we are going to do unboxing and product testing, like always, of this particular projector, that is Epson ESTW750. But before I begin, I want you all to throw your light on this subscription button and continue shining bright just the way these LCD projectors shine, and help us in our mission of giving you enough value so that you can make better, well-informed and right decisions when it comes to buying anything and everything in home technology industry. Epson ESTW750 projector is priced at ₹88,999, and for now this is their first model in the home cinema projector range for Indian markets, and this has been there as a replacement model for the older version, which is ESTW650, which was priced at roughly around 59,000. So that's a massive 30,000 Indian rupees jump for this particular projector, and in this video we are going to check out whether this jump is really worth it. For those of you who have been using 650 or are willing to buy this new projector, don't forget to drop in your comments in the comment section and let us know your views of this particular projector after watching the entire video. Well, so this is the projector that we all have been eager for. Epson ESTW750. It's pretty much same like the 650 model. In terms of picture quality, what is the difference is what we are going to now check. So let's get it hanging and see the picture quality. So here we are with the projector. It's kind of temporary installation. So we've kept it on a chair, and what we are looking at is a 92-inch screen. Now, if you see the home screen, you have got all the functions, all the features of the projector with all the inputs mentioned over here. So we have got HDMI 1, HDMI 2. Now, one of the HDMI inputs supports MHL, that is it, you can connect your mobile directly with a cable to the projector. You have got a VGA support, you have got an analog video output, you have also got USB display. So there are a couple of display USB ports, one which is a type A, which is used for your display purpose, or you know, reading USB document cameras or pen drives, and the second USB port is to connect to your keyboards, mouse, etc. Then we have got LAN, which is primarily for the Wi-Fi purpose, but apart from that, the best benefit that I see in this particular projector compared to its predecessor is the Miracast, and that is what we can see as the screen mirroring option. You have got Keystone support. So Keystone is vertical and horizontal plus minus 30% or 30 degree. You have got split screen, so you can have two inputs playing together side by side. You have got great power consumption, which is the eco mode. So this projector is 3400 lumens on normal mode and 2200 lumens on the economy mode. So as you can see, 2200 on the economy mode is also very, very high, and that's another advantage of this projector, which can be used in a living room or, you know, this kind of ambient lit rooms, and you can still see a great picture on the screen. Then we have color modes, various color modes, bright cinema, dynamic, game, presentation, etc. And well, as I said, it's a very, very compact piece. It's very, very small, very, very bulky, and it's easily portable. So that's another advantage of this particular projector, that it is very, very small in size. The best part about Epson, as we all know, is that it also has quick corners. So with the help of quick corners, you can adjust the screen, or you can fit the image properly in the screen from all the four corners, and you can have a great picture on the screen again. Now we'll just try with the Miracast feature. So I've got a phone of one of my colleagues over here. So let us try to go into the screen mirroring part and see how this video on the phone looks over here. So as you can see, the colors are really very, very bright. We'll also try checking the menu to understand. So you can see it's bright cinema,
We have not played around with the settings. It's a standard by default settings that you can see on the screen there. The only drawback of this particular projector is that it does not support 3D, which I don't really see it as a drawback, because honestly 3D is not that popular technology nowadays. With most of the content that we consume coming in 2D, 3D is really something that we don't require. But yes, I do understand to many of your opinion that this projector is highly priced, overpriced rather, because earlier model, which was a Epson ESD W650, was somewhere around 59,000. That was the MRP. With this particular projector, they have increased the MRP by almost 30,000. Now 30,000 extra you are paying only for two features. One is the Miracast, and second is getting an audio out from this projector and connecting it to any of your sound boxes. So for these two things, if you are willing to pay 30,000 more, then I think you would rather spend couple of, or you know, probably some more thousands and buy the 5650 model, because it has got four times the contrast ratio than this particular projector. Let us try playing some other files. So as you can see, you can play any video from here. Let's say if I want to watch some scene from Bahubali. So the benefit of Miracast is that you don't have to really leave your internet connection of the phone. I can use my 3G network, 4G network, or I can connect it to my existing Wi-Fi network and just cast my phone screen on this particular projector. So I don't really have to leave my Wi-Fi network or an internet connection to join the eye projection. Eye projection is still there in this projector, but with casting, I don't see the need of using the eye projection app at all. If you have got any questions related to this projector, make sure to use the comment section, and I'll be there to answer your questions as soon as possible. For those of you who are looking for a personalized assistance, whether to shop this or are there any other models that they should consider to buy, don't forget to use our services in the description. Me and my team are here to help you, and we will be very, very glad to answer all your queries over there as well. Now, one of the most popular model that is compared with this particular projector is going to be the BenQ TH585 or 685 model. But as I said, if it's living room, LCD is the best solution to go for it, and not a DLP technology. If it's a darker room, then yes, you might have to evaluate some other options. But this particular projector is a big thumbs up for a living room application. The drawback is only the price, which is very, very high. But another win is that it is giving 3 years of warranty. So you have got 3 years projector spare parts covered, except for the lamp, which is 1000 hours or 1 year, whatever comes first. Now, just couple of more features that we forgot to mention. So as I said, 3400 lumens on normal mode and 2200 lumens on the eco mode. The lamp life that company claims is 6000 hours on normal mode and 12000 hours on the eco mode. The fan sound is somewhere close to 37 dB when it's on a normal mode and 27 dB when it's on eco mode. So this is all about this particular projector, guys. I hope to understand, I would love to understand your views on this projector. So feel free to let us know. Make sure to use the comment section wisely, and I, Tanmay Mehta, will continue to see you all in my next video. Thank you.